So in last class we started with association analysis. Okay, so quickly go through what we did in the last class. Okay, and then we'll start with a priori algorithm for finding the association rule. So this was the starting of association rule mining. On the left side you can see market basket transaction, this type of transactions where I said in the last class. So each transaction will have a set of items that one customer can purchase or purchased, already purchased, and there are 5 transactions we can see. Basically, as I said in the last class, association rule mining basically finding the co-occurrence of the item with one item with another item, or a set of item with other set of items. So that is the rule can be written as an implication sign. So here we can see diaper is highly related with the beer, co-occurrence in many transactions. So, and this one also discussed here is this is nothing but the cause and effect case. So it is kind of the co-occurrence. And then we define some few term, what is item, that is the collection of one or more item is called the item set, and key item set means item set length is k. Okay. And then in this connection we define support. Support means how many times that particular item occurred in the transactions, in the all transactions in the database. And then little deviate from the support count is something earlier is called the support count, and this is called the support. Support is like fraction of the transaction that contain the particular item set. So here in one example, milk, bread, diaper, it's occurred twice here also, but out of the how many transactions that give you the support. And then finally we said something called the frequent item set, because if one item occurs on item or one items an item set occurred many times, then we will say is the frequent item set. That many times is also it be decided by the based on the some threshold. And then we said is association rule will be evaluated by the when which association rule will be valid, which association will be a valid one worthy one, that will be decided by the two metrics. So one is something called support, another is the confidence. So this also we discussed, and with one example, say support already we described. What is support? How many times it occur out of the total number of transaction? Here number of transaction is 5. And what is the confidence? Confidence is like how many times occurrence of the entire, if the rule is x to y, so here rule is milk, diaper to beer, so how many times entire item set occurred divided by how many times the left side item set occurred. So that give you the confidence. So now if we have the threshold, so let's say threshold can be different from the support, and it can be different from the confidence also, or it can be same also. And then this is a formal definition of the association rule mining. Given a set of transaction, the goal of the association rule mining is to find the all rule having the minimum support and the confidence. And this is brute force approach, is like list all the possible association rule, so that is computationally very intensive. So therefore we should have some systematic way to solve this problem. Problem is nothing but the finding the association among the item or association rule. So one example you can see on the left side, we have the same database. On the right side we can find the rules. Like rules, if you see here that support remains same, however the confidence of the rule are different. Because support, why support remains same? Because the numerator is the same set, how many times it occurs, but denominator is changing based on the value on the right side. So therefore that confidence is getting changed. So that is the observation is written here. So basically this entire problem is divided into two part. One is first we'll generate the frequent item set generation. So we'll generate the all frequent item set. Frequent means that is each support of the item set will be above some threshold. And once you generate it, then we'll generate the rule generation. So rule generation, like I said in the last class, let's say if you have the this is an ABC is one frequent item set, then you can generate rule ABC. So A to B, B to C, C to A, and similarly A to B C can be, and then B to C A and C to A B. So, these can be generated like and then after not only that, then after generation you have to find the confidence. So, that is, so the entire task is divided into two way. One is either first we in the first step is we will generate the frequent item set, and second step we generate the rule. And then finally, here we said is if you use some brute force approach. So, starting with say we have the 5 item set. So, we can form a lattice. So, like A, B, C, D, E. So, this is something called 1 item set, because length of the item set is 1, and then second level is 2 item set. Similarly, this is 2 item set and this is 3 item set, okay, and this is 4 item set. But in this way, if we generate, then we have the total subset can be generated from the D item set. Is we know that 2 to the power D possible item set will be generated, and this is very exhaustive, but problem is it is computationally intensive. So, then we should develop some algorithm, or this algorithm is already there, those will study to reduce the computational intensive algorithm requirement. So, this is the same way how to, once we generate the candidate, then we have to check, we have to verify whether those items are item sets are frequent or not. So, how do you verify it? So, let us say this is the transaction here, and then this transaction we match with the all candidate item set, and then wherever it is matching, then we will increment it. But complexity, as we said in the last class, will be order of n m w. N is the number of transaction, m is the total number of candidate item set, and w is the width, because you have to match the entire thing to with the candidate item set. So, then we said we can reduce in the 3 ways. We can reduce number of transaction, we can reduce that is number of candidate item set, and obviously the width, okay, that we will study slowly. And then total number of rule is used if you use some brute force approach. So, this can be represented with this one, with only the 6 number of unique item will have the rule 602. Obviously, some of the rule will not be valid, because we have the some confident threshold as well as the minimum support. So, then we talk about the a priori principle. So, a priori principle basic idea is that if an item is frequent, then all of its subset must also be frequent. So, that may be written in more mathematical or formal way. Suppose you have the 2 item set x and y. Obviously, the item set x and y is the subset of 2 to the power d, 2 to the power d, right. So, this is the, we have the power set. So, power set of d. So, x and y will be the subset of this power set. And now, what is that? If x is the subset of y, x is the subset of y, then support of x is always greater than or equal to support of y. Because if you have say a, b, c, say if you got the support 3, and if you consider only a, b, support will be obviously the, at least its support will be, it will be more than equal to 3. Because once you include anything with a, b, if you include anything with a, b, so let us say a, b, c, support will be lesser than the support of the lesser than equal to the support of AB. Because what is support? Support is the times of occurrence. So, AB may occur many times. So, let us say 7 times, but ABC may not occur always more than 7 times. So, it can be maximum of 7 times, but it cannot be more than 7 times. So, therefore, this is the principle, support of the subset will be always greater than the support of Y. Okay. So, this is something called anti-monotone property, and using this one we can reduce the number of item set, candidate item set we can reduce drastically. So, that is they use in the a priori algorithm. What is that? We said is that if an item is frequent, so its corresponding all subset will be frequent. So, we consider in other way around. So, if the item is not frequent, so its superset cannot be also the frequent. So, let us say AB here, AB is found to be the infrequent. So, any item, if you associate with AB, obviously is going to be infrequent, because AB itself is infrequent. So, if you add anything with AB, so that is going to be the infrequent. So, that way you can reduce the number of candidate generation and searching time. So, here we go. So, we can reduce the this set of so many item set generation as well as searching in the data set, we can reduce. So, this is the basic idea of the a priori algorithm. If any subset, any item set is infrequent, its corresponding superset will also will be the, all its superset will be the infrequent. So, one example here, let us we look into in more better way. So, here, so let us say we have the first we got the item set 1, one item set. So, and then we got the count. So, here you see, and then my threshold is here 3. So, therefore, you can discard the, you can discard this item, and you can discard this coke and eggs, you can discard. From here, we can form the two item set. So, now how do you combine it? You combine with bread with milk. So, bread with milk, and then bread with beer, and bread with diaper, and then you combine with milk, coke you can combine, milk with beer. So, milk with beer, milk with diaper, milk with diaper, and then beer with diaper. So, beer with diaper, and then you search the database and you see the number of count here 3, this is 2, this is 2, this is 2, and then 3 and 3 on. So, because it is 2, so we must discard this one, no need to generate the candidate involving the coke or eggs, because if an item set is infrequent, so its superset will be infrequent. So, therefore, we can summarily reject these two item set to be the frequent. There is no chance that these two item will be the frequent in any superset. And then once you combine the bread milk with milk beer, so we will get the bread milk beer diaper. So, therefore, this will be the three item set. So, now what is the advantage after applying the a priori principle? That is, if you go with without using any principle, so if you generate the all possible candidate item, obviously out of the 6 item you have to take 1 item. So, therefore, NC1, and then for second item set you have to take out of the 6 item, you have to choose how many ways you can choose 2 item out of the 6 item. So, therefore, NC2, that is 6C2, and then forming the 3 item set 6C3. So, N is here is 6. So, then number of candidate item will be 41. Now, if we use the just learn that principle, that is anti-monotone principle, if we apply. So, here we had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and here also we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and here we can only we have the one candidate item. Okay. So, total number of candidate will be drastically reduced to 41 to 13. Okay. So, basic principle that if an item is infrequent, its corresponding superset will be the, all its superset will be the infrequent. That is we see. So, whenever bread, beer, it is already this combination bread, beer, if you add anything milk, obviously it is going to be the infrequent. So, therefore, no need for generating the candidate involving the bread and beer. Now, in more formal way, the a priori algorithm. First, you generate the one frequent item. That means, you count the number of occurrence of each item in the transaction database. So, that is let k equal to 1, generate the frequent item set of length 1. You count it and then you discard if it does not support the minimum count. Now, repeat until no new frequent item set are identified. What do you do? What do you do it? Generate length k plus 1 candidate item set from the length of the k frequent item set. So, you are given the length of k and from here you generate the length of k plus 1. Basically, say suppose you have A, B, C, these are the frequent item set. How do you make it two frequent item set? So, you combine with A, B, you will get A, B, combine with A, C, you will get A, C, and then you combine with B, C, so you will get B, C. Okay? Now, you consider these all three are frequent, then how do you make it item set with length 3? So, you combine with AB with AC. So, then AB AA, BC, but this cannot be combined, okay, will come later. So, then this, when you combine it, then what will happen? So, A, this is same, and then we have B, we have C. So, then combine, you will have A, B, C. Okay, I will say this one. So, generate the length k plus 1 candidate item set from the length of the k frequent item set, and prune the candidate item set containing the subset of length k that are infrequent. So, after combining this one, we will again check whether this item set is frequent or not. Okay. Count the subset of the each candidate by scanning the database. So, obviously, how do you check whether this item set is frequent? So, you have to scan the dataset and eliminate that are infrequent, leaving only those that are frequent. Obviously, in the earlier example, you can see here. So, when we will combine with, so these three, we combine with these three. So, then bread, milk. So, we combine with here, let us say we want to combine AB with AC. Then we will get A, B, C. So, similarly, earlier we had A, B and then A, C. So, then we will get it A, B, C. So, A will be common. So, when we are combining AB with AC, so say suppose this length is 2, this length is also 2. So, if we combine, we want to get the length say 2 plus 1. So, then we have to see before the say suppose this is k length. So, before the k minus 1 length, all item will be the same. So, here this is same, then we can combine and form ABC. So, this is one example. Now, is how to count the number of occurrences of the each item. So, say suppose bread and milk. So, obviously, this will form some item set. So, one item set can be bread, another item set can be bread and milk. So, what we do it? We will check, say suppose we want to check this item, whether it is this item set is occurring in the any one of the candidate item set. So, that will be the actually very expensive. So, therefore, what is done is, so hash structure is formed based on the number of unique item present in the transaction data set. So, that how I will do it, then I will come in the next. Let us say, suppose you have the 15 candidate item set of length 3. Okay? So, that candidate item say it is like, first what I said, first you have to generate the candidate item set. Candidate item set means, let us say in earlier example we have, say if I go here, so we have the bread, we will arrange this item in lexicographical order. Okay. So, here if you see the bread will come first, bread will be 1, and then we have coke, so but this is infrequent. So, then what next? No, bread, so before that we have beer, right? So, this will be 1, this will be 2, and then coke. Then what next? So, then we have the diaper. So, this is 3. Then egg. So, it is cross. Then we have, is it right? So, we have beer. Then bread. Then coke. Diaper. And then milk. So, then total unique item set is 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay, so, total number of unique item set is, because after one item set, we will have the 1, 2, 3, 4, these are the total item set. So, what we do it to avoid say like bread and beer and beer and bread. So, it is representing the same item set. What we do it? We arrange the each item set in a lexicographical order. So, this is the arrange here, that is 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, everything will represent as a this number, okay, instead of the original item. Original item also you can do, but it represent the this order 1, 2, 3, 4. And from here, we generate the candidate item set. Once we generate the candidate item set, then we will go for the validating whether the candidate item set is frequent or not. But for doing so, as we have seen, it is computationally intensive. So therefore, what we do it, we'll use the some hash tree structure. So let's say here, suppose we have 15 candidate item set is generated, of each item set length is 3. So it can be 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. So for in this example, how to generate the hash structure of the candidate item set. So we generate the 15 candidate item set. So what are those candidate item set? So these are the 1, 4, 5, one, it can be 1, 1, 2, 4, 4, 5, 7 and so on. Okay. Now I have to generate the hash structure of the candidate item set. So here is the tree for the candidate item set. Okay. Now once we generate the hash tree, now we will go to the each transaction, and the each transaction also will be converted the from each transaction. Let's say I have a transaction 1, 2, 3, 5, 6. From here I will generate the all possible candidate item set, and then I will trace the tree, and then we will increment the counter wherever this is matching with the candidate item set with the, sorry, it is matching the item set contained in the transaction and the item set into the hash tree. So that is, we will show you with one example here. So now here is hash function is on the left side. You can see hash function on the left side. What is that? So there are 3 children here on the root. So and it is using the mod 3 function. So hash function of say let's say h of p is nothing but p mod 3. So what is that? P is nothing but the value of the item. So therefore, if the any item set starting with 1, it should go on the left side. Any item set starting with 2, it will go on the middle, and any item set starting with 3, it will go on the right side, and then it is the P mod 3. So therefore, 1, 4, 7 will go on the left side, 2, 5, 8 will go on the middle, and then 3, 6, 9 will go on the right. So and then while we will form the item set, so we have to follow one principle, that is, let's say if we have the item set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then first we generate the item set 1, 2, then we generate 1, 3, then we generate 1, 4, generate 1, 5. And similarly, we will have the item set 2, 3, 2, 4, 2, 5. So we cannot make 3, 5 is okay. So it should be that item set should be arranged in a order also. So we cannot make the item set 5, 4. Because why so? Because we must have the item set 4, 5, and the item set 4, 5 is same as the 5, 4. So therefore, if we order maintain, if we maintain the order, so then there won't be any chance of the being the duplicate of the item set. Now based on this principle, what we do it, we'll hash the entire transaction here using the hash structure. So how do you do it? So first is 1, 4, 5. So 1, 4, 5 means it should come on the left side because it start with 1. 1, 4, 5 is a transaction, it started with 1. So it should be appearing on the left side. So 1, 4, 5 will be somewhere here. And finally, the all item set will appear in leaf node. And in internal node, so when the leaf node size exceed the minimum number of item set, then we have to split that particular node, so that leaf node become the internal node. Got the point? These are the item set here, and these are the, this is the hash function. So if any item set start with 1, 4, 7, so it must move to the left side. So let's say here 1, 4, 5 on the left side. Consider this is not there, okay? So this is entirely not there. So then we have only 1, 4, 5 on the left side. Then 1, 2, 4. 1, 2, 4 is again starting with 1. So then we have 1, 2, 4 here. Then 4, 5, 7. Again 4, 5 is starting with 4. So therefore, it will go on the left side. So 4, 5, 7. Then 1, 2, 5. Again is starting with 1. So 1, 2, 5. Then 4, 5, 8. So again it will go on the 4, 5, 8. Okay. So now if you see here at this point here, you have how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 item set. But it was initially a leaf node. I said the leaf node cannot have more than 3 item set. So therefore, you have to split this one. Now you split it. Once you split it, then it will have again the same principle. So already 1, 4 is there. So next item is, what is that? Next item was 1, 4, 5, right? 1, 4, 5. So next item 1 is already gone. Then next items it is 4 and 5. 4, where it will appear? 4 will appear on the left side, because here is 1, 4, 7 will come on the left side. So therefore 1, 4, 5 will go to the leftmost side. Now what are the other items? If you see here 1, 2, 4. 1, 2, 4, already 1 is this side, 2 means it will go on the middle side. So 1, 2, 4 will appear somewhere here. So 1, 2, 4 is already somewhere here.